The students, let me solve this example. Here three forces are given, as you can see, and I have to describe the motion of the particle. And here the very first one is F equals to minus 2 into x minus 2 whole cube. We know the general equation of the force, general force equation for the motion of a particle was F equals to minus k into x minus x naught whole to the power n. And when n was odd, that is n equals to 1, 3, 5, 7, etc., then the motion was harmonic motion. And especially when n equals to 1, then the motion was simple harmonic. So here, if we compare these three equations with this standard equation, then we can get the result. Here the very first one is, we can see from the equation that F equals to minus 2 into x minus 2 whole cube. And here the equation is F equals to minus k into x minus x naught n to the power n. Here as n is odd, we can say that this is actually the oscillatory motion of the particle. Oscillatory or harmonic motion, you can say. Harmonic motion. But it is not simple harmonic, because n not equals to 1. That is more higher power, which is greater than 1. So this is a harmonic motion, but not simple harmonic. But the question is that about which point the motion is harmonic. As we know, when F equals to minus k into x minus x naught, then the x naught was the stable equilibrium point, and the particle execute harmonic motion about this point x naught. Here the point is 2. If we compare x naught, here we get 2. So the motion of the particle, which is described by this force, is harmonic motion, and the harmonic motion is occur about the point x equals to 2, and this is actually the stable equilibrium point. We can understand the problem in very different way. That as there is stable equilibrium point, then force must be zero. So if we put F equals to zero, then here we can find that minus 2 into x minus 2 whole cube equals to zero, which implies also x equals to 2. So the stable equilibrium point we can find out by equating force equals to zero also. And when n is odd, then the motion will be harmonic motion. But if n is not odd, then the motion will not be harmonic motion, which I have discussed earlier in the theory part. So number 2, F equals to minus 2 into x minus 2 whole square. Here we can find, or we can see, that n equals to 2 is even value. So this motion is not harmonic motion, as well as not simple harmonic motion, because here n is even. Here n is 1 actually. So n is odd as well as it's 1. So here if we talk about F equals to minus 2 into x minus 2, then this is actually simple harmonic motion. This force describes the simple harmonic motion, because this is equivalent to F equals to minus k into x minus x naught. And here the stable equilibrium point is x naught equals to 2. Here also, if we put F equals to 0, then we get minus 2 into x minus 2 equals to 0, or x equals to 2. So here the simple harmonic motion will occur about the stable equilibrium point x equals to 2. So in this way, we can describe the motion of any particle if the force is given. We can describe the motion by comparing the equation with this general equation, or we can describe the motion by equating the force equals to 0. In any way, we can find the motion is simple harmonic or not, or harmonic or not, and also the point about which the motion will execute harmonic motion or simple harmonic motion. Okay, thank you.